So, biggest update on my VW is I overheated the engine coming back from Bugarama. Bought some new cylinder heads from AA Performance. In general, in reading forums, most people don't recommend these heads. Say the hardware is bad. They're okay to get bare castings and send out, but budget being a big factor right now, I went and got them. So right now, I took off the HD springs, Kamali retainers, and everything from the old heads, because I'm suspecting that's probably better hardware than what came with these AA Performance ones. And so far, actually, I think my suspicions are correct. One of the things I noticed is when I compressed the spring or the valves using the tool, I noticed when I was taking off the old ones that these were able to compress much further before binding up. And when you look at them, I take the thing off, you can see that the coils themselves are thicker on what came on the AA Performance, and they're thinner, and the spring is overall taller on what I had, which is from European Motor Works, I believe. So, plan for now is to swap it over, take the stuff off, keep the valves off. So they're 44 by 36, 44 intake, 36 exhausts. So that's what we're doing right now. So the way I'm doing this is I've got the engine at top dead center for the cylinder that I'm working on. Of course it's compressing. So this one's at top dead center right here, right now. And then when I compress the valve, or I lock the flywheel so it doesn't rotate, because the valves will push against the top of the piston and, you know, push it back, and I won't get the effect that I'm looking for. So that way it's locked. Oops. And with there, the valve spring compression tool, compress it. The valve gets the piston. It gives me just enough wiggle room to knock the retainers off. And boom, that's one valve. And then the trick I'm doing is I'm removing the tool because I can't get this just tension on it. So I have to take the tool off briefly, slide it out of the way, get my out there, slide the tool out of the way, and I got another spring off. And you'll notice, the name escapes me, but the valve spring retainers, I think, they appear different. I'm not sure quality wise if one's better than the other, but I'm gonna go with what I got from European Motor Works. Might as well. And then I'll take a photograph of these little retainers. There is a difference when you look at them. It looks like these are advertised as being like ground and heat treated. You can see, hopefully the camera focuses, how it's been ground, and the finish is nicer. Whereas on these ones, I'll roll in some photographs of them. It's probably better. I'm not sure what the capabilities of this new camera are. So anyway, back to it. left a little bit of footage out. I had to put new piston rings on because when I took the cylinders off, they literally disintegrated, except for one. So your piston rings came in, got the cylinders back on, and I'm in the process of torquing the heads down per the John Muir's idiot guide. Watch side. Get back on video zone. 4 and 5. 6. Start 6. So. For the manual, you'd use the first sketch for just hand tight. And then we're going to torque them now to 7 foot-pounds in the same sketch. So it's just 7 foot-pounds, not very much. But, so, and to alternate the heads. 7. Now, sketch 2, we're going to do 15 foot-pounds. Dial it up. So. Oh, 20 pounds. If you have 36 horse, stripping to 25, but only 23 for everyone else. Don't laugh, this is important. This is type 4. I think we're just gonna go to 20. And I'm sick of going back and forth, so. Last one, 23. Heads are on. So to bring you up to speed at this point, the engine's obviously in, carburetor's on, the exhaust is not on yet, oil lines are hooked up, cable, throttle linkage hooked up, and right now I mocked this up to ensure the alignment of the belt, and now I'm going to take it off and clean it up, put some sealant on the bottom, and throw it back on. So that thing comes out. So now I gotta clean up the bottom half, make sure it's super clean, so when I put the gasket maker on there, it'll be okay. Got a little brake clean, some scotch pad, and a rag. Gasket maker.
So I don't know when my camera stopped recording, but what I was working on was getting this mounted and so that the belt alignment is true. So I've decided, I found a couple washers I'm gonna stack. This one, so that the coil has something decent to like clamp on inside, then it's gonna be the coil right there, then a big washer on the outside, and then obviously the lock nut to close it all off. So we'll see how that works out. There it is, let's have a look, see if we can zoom in there. It's like out of focus. Yeah, so there you can kind of see. Big washer. Yeah, I mean, it'll work. Until I figure out something better. All right, we are back at the wiring adventure. So the 15 side is the hot side coil. So wire, red wire from my distributor, black wire, I believe it goes to. Okay, let's start off. This monkey's nest is the wire. You up here, go to the alternator, we'll do those last. This is easy. This ghetto rig red one, I believe, is power. So it goes to the hot side. Kind of tuck it down under there. Out of the way. This is the oil pressure idiot light. I have oil temperature. Oil pressure gauge replaced, so I either need to figure out a way to mount it on there, or for now it's just gonna sit because I just wanna get the section running. So since I have the CB black box, that's what these wires are. The red's going into the coil, hot side. Cylinder head temperature, it's already plugged in. This prong wire that goes to the oil pressure, which I believe we can get with them right now. Why not? Just kind of routing stuff. And it's like threaded cap, so it's easy. Slip it under, thread it on. Well, that's done. I'll have to review my notes. For the negatives, one negative goes to the distributor, one negative goes on the coil itself. Oh gosh, that's so funny. So the white one goes on the coil, that's this one. Slip it down there. This is for the tachometer. Wires coming from everywhere. No line there. Down. And then the black from the distributor goes to the black and green for the CB black box. That's it. Manifold pressure reference, which is right here for the 3-4 side. And then it's fell down below for the 1-2 side. It's kind of routed weird. You know what? It'll work. rat's nest, but I know what it all means.
Next up is exhaust. Gonna anesthetize that shit. Fuck. Adversity overcome.
Alright, so here's sort of a moment of truth. I haven't even timed it or checked the static timing, but it hasn't changed since I took it out. So I'm just gonna give it a go. I primed the fuel pump, took the lens, and lock it.
Too long. All right, now we gotta tune it or something.